So I had to run this all this shit down to this negra about why I gotta pick my son up, you know what I'm saying, and how come I'm not at the party, you know, sashaying, you know what I'm saying, and duck walking before him and his goddamn partners, okay? So, anyway, and I told him, I said, but you know what, I'll come tomorrow. And I could sense it in his soul that, he was like let down, like, damn, all right. He was like, tomorrow? I said, yeah. I said, well, first of all, look, check this out. If I was coming tonight, so you already anticipated on my motherfucking ass staying the night with you. And I said, but I can't do all that. You know, first of all, look, I don't understand how dudes just automatically assume you're going to get some pussy and shit. I mean, where that come in at? I'm just trying to understand. Where does that come in? Motherfucker, if I'm seeing you, if I come and see you, nigga, that don't mean you gonna hit. That mean that we could probably sit around on some old, nigga, let's go get a bite to eat and all that other kind of old shit. You know what I'm saying? Let's kick it. Let's chill. Let's kick it. Let's talk. Let's have a conversation. Let's sit across the table. How you doing? How your mama them been? You know, why all the motherfucking talk? Nigga, I don't know what it is. Just like with Kenny, when this motherfucker come over, it's like, nigga, it's always like it's bedtime. Nigga, if you don't knock it off, that nigga come here. Nigga, if you don't knock it off, it's like as soon as this motherfucker come in, he like, taking off shoes and shit and all this old type of shit and all that. I'm like, nigga, what's going on and shit? You know? And then this motherfucker right here automatically assume. All right, nigga, whatever. This motherfucker automatically assume that, okay, because I'm gonna stay tonight. So, anyway, bottom line is, girls, the next morning, I didn't call him or text him or anything. But check this out. I told Kenny what was up. I gave Kenny the full 100. Look, check this out, nigga. You ain't been totally 100. I'm just telling you that this is what I'm about to do. So then, therefore, there is no discrepancies. You're going to hear it all from me. You see, that's how I am, girls. I ain't no bullshit in me. I'm a full-grown motherfucking woman running my own shop. I ain't got time to be lying and bullshitting and dragging in no motherfucking body. You know what I'm saying? Because when you tell one lie, you got to tell two or three more of them motherfuckers. I ain't got no time for all that, nigga. This is what I'm about to do. I got a friend coming in from town. I ain't seen this motherfucker in a minute. Excuse me. I'm going over here, going to handle this. I'll be back later on. That motherfucker was here when I got here. That motherfucker was sleeping in the bed like a motherfucker. When I got to this motherfucker, that motherfucker was like, how did it go? I said, nigga, everything went well. Good night. Yeah. But at any rate, girls, ow. Are you ready for this? Baby, I was putting it on Facebook. Okay, y'all seen me in my little aqua motherfucking shirt on, had them jeans on. In those jeans, them white ones, baby, I put them motherfuckers on and shit. And camel toe was sick out the game. Had all this motherfucking shit right here, hugging and scratching the shit and all up on everything. Nigga, what? Check this out. I woke up that morning. I woke up Sunday morning. And I was like, you know what? Look, I gotta do something about my hair game. You know what I mean? So I took all this hair I had. Cause see, you know, I bought so much hair throughout the years. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, okay, look, I got to make me some hair. I already had, you know what I'm saying? I could sew. So it's like, it's nothing. It's nothing for me to do that. You know, I'm a kind of, you know, creative, artsy type of woman. I could do, you know, cold shit with my hands. So it's nothing. So I was like, okay, well, I got a drawer full of this and that, Yaki this, Malaysian that, Brazilian this. Nigga, we finna throw all this shit together. And we finna sew one of this on one of these motherfucking caps. And we about to do it moving. Okay? He texted me Sunday morning. Good morning. Oh, good morning. What time this and that? I said, okay, this afternoon. No problem. I said, I'm going to start getting dressed by 1 o'clock. So at that point in time, I'm making this. This very hair right here I got on. I'm making this. So I'm sitting here. Kenny here. He peeling around. Him and my son. You know what I'm saying? They backyard. Kenny friend came over. So them niggas was back there blowing and cleaning the pool out. No problem. So, you know, and I'm here. I started getting dressed after I whipped, you know what I'm saying, got my butter whipped. I went on, took me a shower, you know what I'm saying, doused it out, you know what I'm saying, threw a little water up, got up under it, you know what I mean, did all that. 1 o'clock, I was putting face on, you know what I mean. I went on down there, and at that point in time, the whole way, I'm like, okay, here we go. Now, And bitch, you already know you ain't seen this motherfucker in 10 fucking years, okay? You already know that you got this motherfucker right here at the house visiting, cleaning pools out, hanging with his partners, all this other kind of shit. You already know this nigga right here, he got a single life going on. He got all this shit going on, nigga. You know, keep your eyes on the prize, bitch. Go over here, go see your friend. Be happy to see him. All of that kind of, and do a moving after that. I got to get nervous. I got to get on Facebook because I had put the picture up there so y'all could see, you know what I'm saying, what I was working with and all this old type of shit. Yeah. So, then I had, what did I do? When I got there to the spot, I got to his partner's, one of his homeboy's house. Beautiful motherfucking house. Live on a golf course and shit. Badass motherfucking house. And the backdrop of his patio is the golf course. He got a nice pool, nice rocked out, waterfalls and shit, TV and barbecue, outside kitchen and shit. Plushed out single. Look, plushed out ass bachelor pad. Do you understand me? Plushed. Okay. This is where these niggas was partying at last night. So when I get there, where your friends at? You ain't got no friends. Whoop the whoop whoop whoop. Where your girls at? And I was like, you know, I don't really, you know, truthfully, in my personal life, I'm a loner. This is where the fuck I dwell at. I get to cut in a lawnmower, bitch, be up in this motherfucker, and I'm minding my own motherfucking business. I don't go nowhere, I don't do nothing, I don't fuck with nobody. But if you come up in this motherfucker, and some shit ringing off me to tell me that you ain't got no code to disarm this motherfucker, nigga, I'm laying you out, your mama gonna pick you out something to wear that's gonna be cold. You understand? Because I don't fuck with nobody, so I'm by myself most times. I handle my own business, I take care of my kids, I cook and I do my own domesticated shit. I made my motherfucking chateau to be able to handle whatever it is that I'm doing. I can do all this right here and it's no problem. So I don't fuck with nobody. You know, I got girlfriends that, you know, when it's that time and we get together, hey girl and all that old type of shit and sangria and all that shit, then that's that time. You know, but they got lives of their own and kids and this and this and this. And I got girls that have not, girls that's doing this and girls that's doing that. So, you know, everybody doing their own thing. When we come together and that's what it is. So, hell, anyway, I was like, well, I ain't got no friends to bring, you know. So, you know, we talking girls, let me tell you. I mean, he was looking so damn sexy. And he's like 6'5", so he's, you know, he's tall and shit. That motherfucker, I said, oh my God. Whoa, this motherfucker all fit and trim and shit, you know what I'm saying? I'm used to big, fat motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying? I'm used to girthy motherfuckers. I'm used to motherfuckers that got a little cholesterol issue, you know what I'm saying? Not saying that that's the shit, but, you know what I'm saying? That's what I'm used to, you know what I'm saying? An AccuCheck motherfucker. Anyway, this motherfucker on a tall glass of everything that I need to dehydrate, to get me together and all that. I said, oh my God, Lord have mercy. When I pulled out outside, and listen, look, I can't do nothing but be honest, girls, look. Because by him following me on Facebook, I was like, okay, maybe he think I'm bullshitting. It's been 10 years. Maybe this nigga want to really see if I am who I say I am. Maybe this nigga really want to see, you know, see me in person, see, instead of seeing a picture, because people can take pictures to make them motherfuckers do whatever, but to see a motherfucker live and direct, see a motherfucker live and Technicolor, live and in 3D, nigga, what can you do about that? It is what it is, you know? So, you know, out of all these many years, he didn't want to see no pictures and all that. That nigga wanted to see all that in live and Technicolor, which I wasn't mad at him, and nigga, I wasn't mad either. I was like, oh, shit. Because when I pulled up, I had called him and told him that I'm inside of the country club, but I'm trying to find the spot right now, and my navigation system has got me, you know, my ETA is like, I'm like within yards of your spot, come outside. So, anyway, when that motherfucker came outside, it just, oh my God, it was like 10 years, and it was like, oh, it's like we just meshed like it, there was never no time apart. I mean, the chemistry and everything was just cool. It was like, oh my God, like we had never been. It was just so fucking cool. Girls, when I tell you this motherfucker picked me up. This motherfucker picked me up. Now, y'all know on Facebook, I'm big about that shit. I ain't got no problem with saying that shit. Nigga, pick my mother. You got to be able to pick me up. Pick a bitch up off the ground. You know what I'm saying? Put me against the wall. Whatever. Handle it. What we need to do. Shit. You know, I'm one of them motherfuckers. So, when that motherfucker picked me up, picked a bitch up, where I'm talking about arms was full of everything, pick up. One of them. Not, no, I'm just going to pick you up, bear hug you, and lift you up off. None of that. I'm talking about one of these. It's a total different get down. When the motherfucker picked you up on one of these, nigga, we fucking tonight. Okay? I'm just going to tell you that part, nigga. Something going to happen in the fellatio coming. Something's taking place this evening. God damn it. Do you understand me? How? Anyway. I had a good-ass time, girls. Bottom line is, I had a good motherfucking time. But let me tell you the bullshit that took place. First of all, now, I'm going to have to do this video about this yoni egg. I got my yoni eggs. I got a mahogany obsidian, and I got and what's my other one? Bloodstone. And so, you know, we're going to talk about the yoni egg and we're going to discuss it all that in depth and all that other kind of shit. But right now, we on this nigga I know. But yeah, that's what we got. We got to cover that and some other shit. But I got you. So, I have been going through my rituals of my little yoni egg and all that other kind of stuff. You know what I'm saying? Tighten up my pussy and all that old type of shit. You know what I'm saying? Not for this nigga, but just because. You know what I'm saying? Bitch on some holistic shit. So, shout out to my lab work, bitch, is healthy as a motherfucking lamb. Went to pap smear, all that shit came out clear, all my blood work, I had posted online so you guys had seen it. And y'all, ever since then, I just been on a high because I was so worried about my fibroid, all that. Wonder, hoping I didn't have any cancerous cells, all those types of things, you know. And so, for it to come back, my fibroid have shrank. They don't even need to do no hysterectomy, no nothing. They like, look, we ain't gonna even fuck with that IUD you got. Is it fucking with you? Are you bleeding excessively? Are you having cramps? No. Okay, well, we're gonna leave that bitch alone. So, and I'm not teeter-tottering on menopausal, no, none of that shit. Bitch is just doing her. You know what I mean? My period come when the bitch wanna come. She leave when she want to. It's usually 2 or 3 days. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it is. Girls, how about that motherfucker came on that night? Ain't that a bitch? How about, and I had those jeans on. The white ones. We decided, he was like, well, let's go to the movies. I want to see Deadpool, right? I was like, I don't even know what the fuck that is, but okay, let's go. We go, and so I let him drive the spaceship because that motherfucker was like, this is a motherfucking spaceship. I was like, you know what? But see, you know what I'm saying? He got a badass whip too, so it's nothing. You know what I'm saying? He drive a same caliber of ride, you know? So it's like, it's no problem, nigga. You accustomed, so it's cool. You know what I'm saying? You got too much shit to lose to fuck me up and my shit, too. You got too much shit to lose, so nigga, here's the smart key. This navigation is gonna take us where we need to go, because I don't know this area. So we get to the movies, you know what I'm saying? We walking and talking and all that. That's when I found out that my period was on while I was in the car. And I was like sitting down in the car and shit, you know what I'm saying? And I had did one of these. And I was like, wait a minute, hold the fuck up. Wait a minute, hold on, you know what I'm saying? In white pants. But, you know, when I began spotting, I didn't have no panties on. So it was like, nigga, it just went straight on, went right on through. But it was not... It was like a little spot, but it wasn't like red. It was like, you know, that real light, like the lightest pink you can go where it's almost clear, but it got like a tinge to it, whereas it's like, what's going on? It was that type of situation. It was like so minute, but see, that lets you know I'm so in tune with the power of my motherfucking pussy. I watch this bitch all the time. She like the stock market. She bitches, we good? Oh, okay, we good then. Yeah. Yeah, I watch this bitch all the time, you know what I mean? So, you know, hey, I just happened to look down and seen that there was an issue, so I was like, okay, no problem, but a bitch always stay ready, you know what I'm saying? Bitch had tampons and things of that nature in her purse, got me a whole kit, so, and I had no idea that my period was gonna come, and this bitch just showed up. I was like, oh, shit, ain't that a bitch? So when we get to the movies, as soon as we got there, we parked, and I was like, well, I'm going to go in to the bathroom, and, you know, while you get the tickets or whatever. He went up to the door and said, you know, she needs to use the bathroom. I'll give her a ticket when I, you know what I'm saying, handle this. The dude at the gate, at the door was like, oh, sir, no problem. You know what I'm saying? I was like, oh, look at this shit right here. Yeah. So I go to the bathroom, grinning on the inside like a motherfucker. Handled that, even took my pants off, cleaned that, because it was really nothing, you know what I'm saying? And I didn't give a fuck that it was bitches in there, whatever, bitch. I'm cleaning my motherfucking pants up. Do what you got going on. And I'm standing up there with my aqua blue shirt on, not a damn draw on, Tampax in, though. And I'm at the motherfucking water doing this right here. Had the blow dryer going, dry that right there, and it was cleared up, clean, no problem. It was like nothing that never happened. You know what I'm saying? I'm a G. Anyway, I go out there as soon as he see. He's like, damn, I'm seeing motherfuckers coming in and out. You damn shit. What was wrong? You know, he looked like, what happened? What's wrong? You know what I'm saying? I was like, oh, nothing, baby. I'm good. I'm good. At this point in time, I know he was like, damn, what did she do? We get in there. The movie was a good movie. I had a good time. The movie was good. All through the movie, this motherfucker was caressing and rubbing and shit. Nigga, I was hot as a motherfucker. I said, oh my God, this nigga got me on some Saudi Arabia and this motherfucker. I'm trying to be cool and shit. I don't want to get upset, overreact, but God damn, and this nigga sexy and shit. His breath smell good. You know what I mean? I'm like, oh my God. What the fuck is happening? You know, what's... Girls, I was miscombobulated. Like, what's going on? After the movie, we get back to the car, and we get back to his friend's house. That's where he was staying the night. And, you know, when we get there, it's niggas still parlaying and kicking and watching TV, and, you know, they shooting pool, and, I mean, nigga, this is Saturday afternoon and shit. Like, it was like that, because here all his little friends had flown in and came in, and everybody's flights were leaving Monday. So... He, just like his flight was leaving on Monday, he was going back home and, you know, and all this. So we get back in there and everything. We go upstairs, we go to the room and, you know, we sitting around and shit. And, you know, and that motherfucker just, man, look. Girls, look. He changed his clothes. He put these little shorts and shit on. Little, you know, little basketball, little hooping shorts and shit. Now, first of all, this nigga's dick been hard since I got to this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? The motherfucker been trying to play it out. Motherfucker had put it up to where the motherfucker was right up. You know, had how they sometimes put their dick up to where it be facing their neighbor and shit. So then therefore don't show that the motherfucker's like that. So the motherfucker was readjusting his shit all throughout the night. So I was like, okay, nigga, why you here, you know? So when we got back and he changed his shorts, now, nigga, ain't no hiding. Now, nigga, it's what it is. You know what I'm saying? I seen it when I first got here. When you picked me up and all that shit, nigga, I came down and landed on the flagpole. I was like, wait, what the fuck? Something on my ass right quick. He's like, don't worry about it. It ain't nothing. I said, oh, okay. Shit, well, I guess it ain't nothing then. Shit. Woohoo! Girls. And they got a big old dick, though. He had a big old dick, girls. Listen, that motherfucker had a big old dick. And the cold part about it is, y'all know I ain't accustomed to all that. So that shit had me fucked up. I was like, wait a minute, what's going on here? It's like the last few niggas that I have met have had big ass dicks. And I don't know if this shit is in the wind or is this, what the fuck? Because this is just something I'm not really accustomed to. I'm tripping out on this motherfucking shit. I'm like, what's up with this big dick shit going on around here? It's something swarming around this motherfucker. We're getting invaded. Something's going on. What the hell's happening? Oh, my God. You know what I mean? This motherfucker had a big ass dick. So what is a bitch to do like me? What is a G to do? I mean, what is she to do? Bottom line is, I had a very good night. I'm fully grown. Don't give a fuck, okay? And so we had a very, very, very good fucking night. We had a very good night. And this motherfucker, okay, so we laying in the bed, right? How about I got ready to get up, my motherfucking hair came off. I said, God damn, ain't this a bitch? I got ready to get up, you know, and you know how like you be laying in a man's arms and you know what I'm saying? Y'all laying there, we watching TV, you know what I'm saying? I got ready to get the fuck up. This was before, you know what I'm saying? This was before everything. This is when we first got in there and everything. I got ready to get up. My motherfucking hair was right there, nigga. And I was like, oh my God. Boop. All I can do is put my motherfucking shit back on, nigga. Keep pushing, nigga. What? No problem. But then after that, I was like, you know what? Fuck it. You know what I'm saying? I got hair. Shit. Fuck it, nigga. You done already seen it now. I took that motherfucker off. He was like, oh, shit. Okay. Girls, I took this motherfucker off. I didn't give a damn. I took the motherfucker off. Fuck it. Bop, nigga. Keep the party rolling. Shit. Fuck it. We ain't gonna worry about that, nigga. Do you see that? I ain't seen nothing. What we doing? And so, but the bottom line is, that was the first time, I have to say, and it wasn't him, it was me. I wasn't ready. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't ready because I just felt like, and nor do I feel like I was under arrest. I don't feel like this was a Bill Cosby motherfucking incident. It was none of that old type of shit. Let me just go on and be crystal clear on that. Okay. I'm fully grown. Okay. I stand accountable for my motherfucking actions. I'm not a liar and I'm all the way the truth. I don't give a fuck about how it look or how it may seem to another motherfucker. Look, check this out. Hey, nigga, there's nothing to remember. You asked me the same motherfucking thing, nigga. It's what it was. Well, my hair fell off. I went on, took that motherfucker off. Period started. Then I was like, you know, this motherfucker really wanted me to just, you know, let me see everything type shit. This motherfucker was like, shit, cut on all these motherfuckers. That motherfucker cut on the bathroom light, cut on all the motherfucking lights in the room. And I was like, this nigga's a trip. You know what I mean? This motherfucker was looking at my toes and that motherfucker wanted to see everything. He was like, fuck it, take all that shit off. Just take it off. That motherfucker was looking at every motherfucking thing I had. You understand me? Every motherfucking thing I had. And I don't know if it was a fact that, okay, it's been 10 years. You know, we used to be so close back then. You know, we have grown up so much. Nigga, all this time I've been checking you out on Facebook and shit. Whenever I get that ass, I'm getting that ass. Whenever I see you again, I'm getting that ass. I don't know if it was one of them, but the passion in the room, it was overwhelming. I was like, oh my God, nigga, what's wrong with you? Shit. This motherfucker was, I mean, this nigga was all over my motherfucking ass. I mean, all over me, just all on my back and laying on top of my back and all of just all over my motherfucker. I was like, oh my God, nigga, what's wrong with you? You know, and it was like, but I have no regrets. I have absolutely no regrets whatsoever. I allowed my heart to take that chance. And you know what I'm saying? It is what it is. I'm still an OG. You know what I mean? It is what it is. And I ain't running from a motherfucking thing. The message has been received. Holla. On that note, girls, deuces. I'm going to holla at y'all in a minute. I got some shit to talk about. All right, I'm going.